This Diwali Bazaar is a uniquely pleasurable shopping experience. This is where when you shop, you also contribute to the cause of some special people who themselves are not able to see but have spared no efforts to light up the lives of others. Away from the crowded bazaar, this small group works away busily on candles. Big degjis filled with wax are melted and continuously kept on the fire to keep hot and molten. The diyas are washed with cold water and lined up across the tables to be filled. The molten wax is carried in these small kettles and then carefully poured into each earthen pot. For the wicks, small round metal clips are punched into a hole, while long strips of wax-covered thread are cut into pieces and inserted into them. They are then clipped together, making a wick. Trying my hand at the process, I too got going at the diyas while the wax was still hot.
One of the purposes of Diwali Bazaar, and it serves automatically, is that people get to know the abilities and capabilities of persons with visual impairment. It may start with candle, but behind candle you must have seen we have some visually challenged person giving demonstration of relaxation massage there. And then people get to know that the blind persons can even work on computers. We have a school, then we tell them about. So people get to know about the capabilities, and that's a very important thing. And I hope this Diwali Bazaar, we all wish that people should understand that the persons with disabilities have equal right and they should be given equal opportunities to play as a member of, a useful member or a contributing member to the society.
Along with the diyas, the volunteers also make candles of different shapes and sizes. Color is added to the molten wax to create the diyas of varying shades. Hot wax is poured into iron molds. On cooling, they are given a cool water dip to solidify them further. Finally, they are dipped into the hot wax again in order to get a coating and shine. Diwali is a very special occasion for the association. Economically, it is also their busy season, so every day without fail, work starts early and goes on till evening. The bazaar stretches over 6 days, which means they are working to a deadline with both targets and orders to complete.
This is the very first time that I'm actually visiting the Blind School Mela, and trust me, I'm so impressed. I mean, it is amazing to know that blind people, you know, people who actually cannot see, have made such lovely stuff. And I, from the bottom of my heart, I feel that I feel so happy that my money is being utilized in helping somebody.
The bazaar has many newer and out-of-the-box items for customers this Diwali. Colorful rustic hanging lamps in glass, hand-painted drawers, metal hangings of Ganesh, and colorful candles in glass jars are a huge hit. Modern versions are experiments with angles and wooden hands holding diyas. If you want some green decor, then the bazaar has adequate stalls selling fancy flowers and trimmed shrubs. Lanterns made of colorful cellophane sheets are modeled along the lines of Chinese lanterns.
For me, it's a little bit like feeling at Christmas time with all the lights and everyone is buying something. And so it's a very nice experience to be here in India in this time during the year.
This year is much better. The people are buying much things for decoration. They are trying to decorate their house as best they can. So I think this year people are enjoying more. People are getting aware of this thing. They are buying more ethnic style these days. Like previously 4-5 years, people were not aware of these things. They were not buying, but slowly and slowly people are getting more aware to buy these ethnic style of goods which are originally from their country only.
Mera chana bana hai tar leke jana babu ghar dena bibi ko jaakar bibi boli muskura kar kahan se laaye ho devar mujhe bata do chane wale ka ghar main ud jaungi far.
Food is one of the essential items of any mela, and this bazaar has just the right things to offer. Cotton candy, the pink fluffy sugar cloud, is a staple that I simply couldn't resist it. From the hot aloo tikkis and the cool and crunchy golgappas, there's something on the plate for everyone, be they young or old. Rajasthani kachori and a variety of chaats are the other dishes to relish.
I'm coming on this mela from last 7 years. The reason of coming and attending this mela is only to buy the candles and the diyas which they make, so that you know we can help and we can associate with the blind school in different manners. You know, it gives people to come across and celebrate Diwali in different manner altogether. Come eat all the pav bhajis and all the pani puris of the world at the one common place, and come and see other stuff which is like for the Diwali gifting purpose and everything.
Sparkling lights and happy faces all around, that's what you look for in a fair. And with the festival spirit in the air, the Blind Relief Association's Diwali Bazaar packs in a complete experience. With fancy lights and lanterns, decorative diyas and candles, and stalls selling foodstuff, the annual bazaar is a fitting place for your Diwali celebrations.